Hey everybody, Jeff Knight here from 7-Minute AE Tutorials. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to make shape layer matte transitions that reveal footage in a sequence. We'll be creating four transitions on just one layer and saving it as an animation preset. If you're looking for an effective way to reveal your footage with transitions, then this is the tutorial for you. Check out the links in the description for the project file, as well as animation presets, templates, and ways that you can help support this channel. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so I have these four video clips here, and we're going to be creating four transitions on just one shape layer. It's something that you can save as an animation preset and call it back up in your effects and presets panel and bring it into any project. Okay, so let's get going. The first thing I'm going to do is select all of these layers. And let's just hide those for now, so that way we can focus on our shape layer. Right click in this area that's to the left of our timeline and choose new shape layer. I'm going to rename this layer to transitions. Open that up and let's go to our add button. Let's add in a group and we're going to rename this to one. Then let's add in a rectangle and a fill. Notice that our composition is 1920 by 1080. That's very important because the math that we'll be doing for this tutorial depends on our comp size. So if you have a composition that's a different dimension, like 1080 by 1080, your math is going to be a little bit different. We're going to go with 1920 by 1080. Bring our rectangle and our fill into this group one here. So open up our rectangle path. The way we're going to make this transition is we want it to come in horizontally. So we want to make our size setting 1920 for the X value. And then for our Y value, we want to take 1080 because that's the height of our comp and divide that by 3. And we get 360. We're going to make three of these little stripes here. We need to place them using this position setting right here underneath our rectangle path. For our first one, let's move our Y position to negative 360. Since our size is 1920 by 360, we need to place these on the Y axis 360 pixels away from each other, the first one being negative 360. Rename this rectangle path A. Now let's duplicate A. We get A2, but let's rename that to B. We open that up, let's move our position down to 0. Now if we take B, duplicate that, we get B2, but let's rename that to C. Open that up, and let's change our position to 360. So now, all three of these rectangles fill up our entire composition. We can see that our Y position values are 360 pixels away from one another. They are negative 360, 0, and 360. So now we just need to animate these on using the position of these rectangle paths. So I'm going to put a keyframe at the very beginning, and then let's close up that layer, then press U to reveal those keyframes. That way it's just a lot easier to work with this animation. Then I'm going to shift page down 3 times to move forward 30 frames. Let's add in a second set of keyframes. I'm just going to zoom in here so we can see a little bit better. And now let's make all of our X values 1920 for this first keyframe. So 1920, 1920, and 1920. And as we scrub through here, we can see how they're all going to move in. So let's select all of these keyframes, F9 to make those easy ease. I'm going to select this second set of keyframes and go into my graph editor and just pull that handle all the way over to the left. And so this is going to be the speed of our transition. Offset these keyframes by 3 frames each. So page down 3 times and move those keyframes over. So now if we watch it play back, we can see how this is going to be animating in. I'm going to duplicate 1 3 times, so that way we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then let's go up to our Finder toolbar and type in Scale. This is what's going to give us the different directions for our transition. And let's just unconstrain this scale for this second group. In Group 1, our scale value is 100, 100. So let's make Group 2 100, negative 100, and that's going to flip it horizontally. And then for Group 3, let's make this negative 100, negative 100, and that's going to flip it horizontally and vertically. And then for Group 4, we're going to make it negative 100, 100. That's going to flip it vertically. So let's just check out these transitions. Group 4 here is going to come in from the left, top to bottom. Group 3 will come in from the left, bottom to top. Group 2 will come in from the right, bottom to top. And Group 1 is going to come in from the right, top to bottom. We just need to add in some expression controls to tell this layer when to use which transition. So if you right-click and choose Effect, go up to Expression Controls, and let's add in a checkbox control. Now I'm going to rename this to 1, and then just duplicate that to make 2, 3, and 4. Go to our Finder toolbar And let's just type in opacity. Now the opacity that we're looking for is under our transform. So we can close up all of these fills here. We just want to focus on our opacity for transform. I'm just going to pull this up so we can see a little bit better. Link all of these opacities for these groups over to their corresponding checkboxes. So 1:1, 2:2, 3:3, and 4:4. Press EE. That will reveal these expressions. And at the very end, just type times 100. I'm just going to copy that and then paste it to the end of these other expressions. And the reason why we're doing times 100 is because we're going to be telling After Effects this layer is either going to be 0 times 100, which equals 0, or 1 times 100, which equals 100. So if the checkbox isn't selected, then our opacity will be 0 or invisible. And if it is selected, it will be 100 or visible. So by doing that, we can toggle through all of these different options and pick which transition we want to see. Let's go down to where our last keyframe is and Alt right bracket to trim that. Now let's go to this second video clip and press I to go to the beginning of that layer. Select that transition, left bracket to bring it over. Then we'll do this for the rest of these clips. Select that third clip from the bottom, press I to go to the beginning of that layer. We're going to duplicate the transition, left bracket to bring it to our playhead. And then that fourth clip from the bottom on layer 4, select that, press I, duplicate our transition, left bracket. And finally, on layer 4, we're going to select that, press I, then duplicate our transition one more time and left bracket. Click on each one of these transitions and toggle a different option, so that way we can see how they come in from different directions. And if we click on each layer, we can see in our Effects Controls panel how these different checkboxes are selected. Okay, now I'm going to turn these layers back on. Okay, now let's drag each one of these transitions on top of their corresponding clip, like this. And these are actually going to be alpha mats, so we do need the shape layers to be extended to the length of the clip that's going to be visible. So let's just grab these three and stretch those over. Make sure you have your track mat column visible. If not, right-click up here, select columns, and make sure modes is enabled. Okay, now let's take each one of these video clips, and we're going to alpha mat those to their corresponding shape layers, like this. So now that's going to hide our shape layer and reveal our footage. So let's just watch this play back, and you can see how this is going to work. So our first transition comes in from the top right, second one comes in from the bottom right, then bottom left, and top left. So we have four transitions on just one layer, and we can toggle these options off and on. Now let's say this has an animation preset. You can select any one of these shape layers because they're all built the same, and just make sure you have contents, effects, and transform selected. Now we're going to go up to animation, save animation preset, and you want to drop this into your documents, Adobe, the version you're using, I'm in 2023, user presets. And now I have a folder for 7-Minute AE. You can either drop this right into your user presets, or you can make a folder structure the way I have. And I'm just going to call this mat_transitions. Click save. Now I always like to make sure that my animation presets save properly, and I don't have my effects and presets window open. So let's go up to window and choose effects and presets. There are two ways to get to your preset. You can either go right into your user presets folder, if you know exactly where it is. And under 7-Minute AE, we see that's the animation preset we just saved. You can also search for it. So in the search bar, I'm going to type mat_ and start to type transitions, and we can see it's right there. Now to add this to your comp, make sure there is no layer selected, and then you can simply double click that preset. This preset has keyframes. After Effects is going to drop your first keyframe wherever your playhead is. As you can see, my playhead is somewhere between 3 and 4 seconds. So if I press U, you can see that's where the keyframes are. So I'm just going to get rid of that. I'm going to move my playhead to the very beginning. And then again, double click Mat Transitions, select U, and you can see our first keyframe is dropped right where our playhead is. And that's how you can create four transitions on just one shape layer, save it as an animation preset, and bring it back in with just a click of a button.